having a good time tonight. This next song was written by a young man that was so in love with his woman, he just couldn't see his life without her. So he committed the ultimate sin and took his very own life. But the words of this song are cemented in our hearts forever. Can we sing it for you? Can we sing it?
Once again. us in the balcony.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Are you enjoying yourself so far? Beautiful, beautiful. But right now, we'd like to do a song for you that was recorded by the Temptations along with a very, very popular group. I'm sure you're going to recognize the name when we say it. Miss Donna Ross and the Supremes. Somebody says, I'm going to make you love me. Sometimes in relationships, things don't always turn out the way we would like. Sometimes you can even find yourself on the outside looking in.
You can't give all the wrong outcomes.
But you know what? We've been doing this shit for
61 years.
That sounds so good. You better tell them the other part.
Other part?
Yeah.
Must I?
Come on, baby. You know.
What is what he's talking about is he would like for me to tell everyone that
I'm 82 years old.
You're still doing strong.
I'd like to make a very special announcement because a lot of acts, I don't know if they forget or whatever, but the 10th, we're going to acknowledge the real stars who's in the house tonight. It's not the Four Tops. It's not the Temptations. You know who the real stars are? You all are. You know, when you decide to get up off of your hard-earned money and you decide to come out into these crazy streets that we're living in and you have to deal with all the whatever that's going on and you come out here to see us, you know, you decide to get up off of your hard-earned money to come out here. You all are the stars, not us. If it wasn't for you, we would not be around 61 years later. So I have to acknowledge it. Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you. Thank you.
Yeah, I'd like to tell you a few things here, you know, about the Temps, Motown, and what have you. You know, like I will always say, there will never ever be a recording company like Motown.
You showed me it down there, didn't you? No, the reason I said that because the there will never ever be a recording company like Motown. Now, the reason I specify that is because no other recording company in the business, CBS, Warner Brothers, Polydor, all these up and coming, no, they're not up and coming, they're big, they got money from now on, you know. But yet, you see, Barry started Motown, check this out, Barry started Motown with $800. Yeah, he sold it, he got bigger books, you know, so but, you know, what made Motown so uniquely different was that they had a division called Artist Development. So I guess you said, what recording company would have a company, a division called Artist Development? Motown. See, Mary Gordy and Harvey Fuqua. Now, Harvey Fuqua is the same with the famous Harvey and the Moonglows. So one day they were in Barry's office and Barry said, you know, we have all this wonderful talented artists that they need to be cultivated. They need to be spit shined, groomed to when they go out in front of the public, they know how to present themselves, you know. So Harvey said, well, I know some people that can do that, Barry. Barry said, well, go ahead on Harvey. If you can find them, bring them on here and let's do this. And the division, like I said, was called Artist Development. And they hired some wonderful thespians that taught us about building show business. First, all this stuff that you see the Temps do, I have to give credit first and foremost to the late, great Paul Williams. Yes. And in fact, we have Paul Williams' nephew, Adrian Williams, playing guitar for us. Adrian! I told you about him, but he hired a guy by the name of Charlie Atkins. Now, Charlie came in after Paul teaching us a lot of intricate stuff. You know, I'm gonna tell you how the pops used to talk to us. You know, if we mess up, boy, move your ass. You can't go to Cleveland if you ain't Cleveland. Move your ass, boy. That's what your pops would know. We said, Pop, well, yeah, he said, I want you to learn my stuff. You know, so very intricate stuff, you know. So he taught us a lot. He taught us about how to be in show business, what to do and what not to do. You know, so, and then that was the late, great Maurice King. Yeah. Ooh, woo! Oh, y'all hear me, Maurice King? Let me tell you about Maurice King. a great vocal coach. You know, Maurice King was teaching us, you know, very intricate harmonies, like the modern jazz, the four freshmen, the high lows. The kind of harmony you better stay on your pitch, because if you got off it, bam, snap your tie in. Boy, did I tell you that's the wrong note? Same mind note, right, you know. Yes, sir, Pops, we won't do it again. You know, he was that kind of disciplinarian, you know. But we loved it because it made us who we are today. Then they had another great choreographer, Lawrence Fontaine, who taught us a lot of stuff, and then Jenny Allen, our keyboardist, you know. So Larry has some wonderful people who teach not only the Temps, the Four Tops, the Supremes, the Marvelous, the list is endless, because they wanted us to go into the smart ones. Now, when I say smart ones, sure, we played Vegas and a lot of the very high-end rooms, but let me tell you something about the place that I'm getting ready to tell you about. Five brothers from down south, we came to Motown. It's the Chinas. Then we had to go to the Copacabana. That's what we said when we were told we went in there. Yeah, so we went in there. We broke every attendance record that was ever held at the Copacabana. Yeah. Now, we're talking about women that the great Frank Sinatra, Sammy Davis Jr., Dean Martin, Perry Como, those kind of clientele, they would be in there, you know. But here we come, and we did all that wonderful stuff, and, you know, I never would imagine, you know, like I've always said, you could have tipped me over with a feather, so I believe that we would do such wonderful, you know, events, you know. And then, there's a lot I can go and tell you about. You'll be talking about, Tim, we love to hear you talk, but we want to see you sing, too. You know? But one of the things that I like to say is that we have a brand new CD out. The name of it is Temptation 60. Now, there's something I'm about to do for you. Let me tell you how it came about. So when we got the green light, Derek and myself, we were riding around one of LA's many freeways, and I said, Dee, we're getting ready to do our 60th anniversary album. I never would have imagined that. And he said, I said, it would be great for Smokey to do it. He said, oh, does she know I'm calling? So I called Smokey. For 61 years, Smokey has always referred to me as Oak, O-A-K. I said, hey, Smokey, we're getting ready to do our 60th anniversary. We'd love for you to be a part of it. No problem, Oak. So I said, we would love for you to write it. You got it, Oak. Produce it. You got it, Oak. Not only that, we would love for you to sing with us on it. Oh, no problem, Oak. You got it. So, okay. We went in and did it. Now, before I tell you the title, the young man to my left, your right, he starts the song off. He sounds so much like Smokey. You know what we call him? Chocolate Smokey. And the name of the song is it going to be yes or no? But touching is her silent lovemaker.
Yeah. Is it gonna be yes or no? Oh yeah. Is it gonna be yes or no?
No, no, no.
Ooh, 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 ooh.
Is it gonna be yes or no?
Baby, baby, baby.
Is it gonna be yes or no?
Baby, baby.
Is it gonna be yes or no?
Very important to us because they keep the beat to keep us moving our feet. On the keyboards from Los Angeles, California, show your love for Mr. Michael North, please. On the guitar from Detroit, Michigan, Mr. Adrian Williams, one more time. On the drums from Los Angeles, California, Mr. Darren Derrick. The bass guitar from Memphis, Tennessee, Mr. Selden Cole. How about a big round of applause for this wonderful horn section, ladies and gentlemen? Doing a wonderful job. And they're all under the leadership of our own maestro himself from New York City. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Dennis Williams. The doctor's in the house. Now that you've met us vocally, we'd like to take this opportunity to introduce ourselves to you personally. Singing first tenor, second tenor, baritone, and a lot of lead. He's from Charlotte, North Carolina. Ladies and gentlemen, show your love for Mr. Tony Grant. Ladies and gentlemen, our James Brown in training. Now the next gentleman, no matter where we travel in the world, we call his name, let me just say the ladies scream real loud. Why? Otis, you know, you and I, we've been trying to figure this thing out for a long time. How come we don't get that kind of confidence? But you know, ladies and gentlemen, he's from Birmingham, Alabama. Please show your love for Mr. Babyface, Jerry Wheat. What we call the new kid on the block. But only in this case is the new man on the block. And you know what? When you're a new guy on the job, a lot of duties come along with it. And you know, we travel with about 40 to 50 pieces of luggage. Somebody gotta do it. It ain't me. It ain't Otis. It ain't Tony, it ain't Jerry. Somebody got to do it. But he does a wonderful job, ladies and gentlemen. He really does. And you know, his main thing that he has to worry about is every night after the show, he has to find Otis a midnight snack. You know, and most stores are closed that time of night. So what does he have to do? He has to get an Uber. What's the other one called? Uber, or whoever it is. They have to take him somewhere, 7-Eleven or something, get something for Otis to eat because we can't let the boss be mad. But he does such a wonderful job that we love him to death. You see, he comes from Otis's book, the Broadway play, Ain't Too Proud. And guess what? We're proud to have him with us on the front line. Ladies and gentlemen, show your love for Mr. Jawan Jackson.
Oh, lucky son of a boy. Power man, power man, power man, power
You feel me? Sounds good. I gotta say this. You're making my wonderful friend Melvin Franklin up there in heaven with God very proud because you're holding down that place real good. Thank you.
Now, this next young man, you see, he's been with me for such a long time. He hails from Philadelphia. Well, he's a wonderful friend to have, and he's a great asset. But let me tell you what the young man can sing. The brother can sing some audacious for seven. He's cold-blooded on second jelly all day long. Sweet baritone.
Brother can't change no bass. No, I don't wanna wait no place.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Hold on. Why you gonna say it like that?
I'm gonna fall for that. Let's say hi to the wonderful tenor of Mr. Ron Duper Tyson.
It's like a heaven, whether it turns true. so much in my life.
Now I'm Make some noise in here. Yeah. Up top, what about you? You having a good time still? Yeah. Now for this next song, I want to dedicate it to a special lady in the audience, Miss Renee. It's her birthday, and we want to dedicate the Temptations National Anthem to you.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together. We've been in the middle of this hole. These are the Temptations.